school children aware of themselves as consumers? How much do they need to know about consumer affairs? The editors of Byline newspaper went to talk to a group of 14-year-olds at the Elliot Comprehensive School in Putney.
My name is Norman Tozer, and I'm a journalist. I call myself a consumer affairs commentator. I've done quite a lot of things that have brought me to the point of editing this newspaper called Byline. At about that time, I was working with Marion Jordan, and that's where she comes into the picture. My co-editor, Marion.
We're co-editors, yes. I'm also a consumer journalist, but I worked within the consumer movement, as it's called. Can you tell me, what is a consumer?
Someone who buys food from a shop.
Yes.
And consumes it.
Food?
Or any goods.
Any
clothes,
goods, yes.
Shoes, anything.
Services?
Yes, so.
Bus, telephone?
Everything.
I was just going back on this business of being a consumer and trying to sort of see ways in which one is a consumer. No prizes for guessing what that is.
Ticket.
Bus ticket, exactly. In fact, it's a contract. It's a consumer contract. Hands up, what's a contract? Look, she's trying to duck away. What's a contract? Anybody like to define what a contract is?
Oh, the commerce lot again. Yes, come on.
I think it's an agreement between two parties.
Mm-hmm.
Business agreement.
Yes. It's an agreement between two parties framed within what? But it's made within the law, isn't it? Because you couldn't make a contract to murder somebody legally. No. Well, so the contract is made within the law. And so buying and selling obviously comes within the whole area of the law as well. Right, well, that's one aspect of being a consumer. So let's talk about what enables you to be a consumer, and that's money. Hands up those who get pocket money. Hands up those who've got a job that brings them in other money. All right. Hands up the people who get below £2 a week from their job.
Is it a newspaper round?
No, window cleaning round.
Window cleaning, is it? Yes. Does anybody do a newspaper round?
You don't work
do
up
you?
North
yes.
London way, do you?
I work with
yes.
In an evening newsman.
Uh-huh.
And I give papers out to shops.
So does anybody do any shelf filling? Yes, you do. Whereabouts?
Putney.
In what sort of a store is it?
A supermarket.
Uh-huh. How often do you go and do it?
After schools on Saturday.
Yes. Shelf filling, I reckon you can... You're paid by the hour, are you?
Yes.
Yes. You can earn about between £4 and £5 a week, can you? Mm. Something like that.
How many of you work in shops on Saturdays or in the evenings or whenever?
I don't work in a shop, I work in a hospital.
Have you got a second job?
You've got another job?
Yeah.
So you can either swap or you can buy money or you can earn money.
Does anybody do the shopping for their money? You do. Yeah, you're busy, aren't you?
Yeah. Yes. Very busy.
Yes, you do. Do you actually choose? Does she tell you what she wants? Do you choose?
Well, she tells me what to buy, and if I got more money on me, I just buy stuff as well.
Yes. So actually, you're choosing for the family,
yeah,
aren't you? So, whereas, as well as them choosing things for you, you're actually choosing to spend their money for them, aren't you? That's another way, really, in which you're consumers. I wonder, do you all think that shoes are made of leather? No? Does anybody here think they've got leather shoes on?
Debatable.
Debatable, yes, yes. Has anybody got leather-soled shoes on? What?
Leather soles, I have.
You have?
Yeah.
Show me.
How do you know?
Well, actually, I reckon... Excuse me, yes, I reckon he's right.
Yes, but how do you know?
Because, my dad, he used to be a shoemaker.
Hands up those who've had to take a pair of shoes back because they've been a problem. Could somebody lend me one of those high-heeled shoes for a moment? Just take... anybody
can,
got
can,
a pair
we,
that comes off easily?
Yes.
Yeah. And I'll tell you why. Thanks very much. Now, all right, forget the sort of fashion aspect of that for the moment, but just look at it as a piece of engineering, a piece of technology. What does it need to keep it together?
Glue.
Glue, yes. Tax, yes, there are very often tax around there. It's a piece of technology, and actually to put the weight of a person on that shoe, that structure, means that it's subject to all sorts of stress.
Yes, can I explain to you that goodness, this is heavy. It's very heavy, isn't it? The whole technology of it is means that you're actually testing out a new product and you're actually having to pay for it at the same time. And that's really one of the reasons why there have been so many complaints about shoes. Do you ever complain about other kinds of things that go wrong? Has anybody bought clothes that they haven't found something wrong with? Have you? Yes?
Yeah, but they've been not being sewn properly.
Oh, something not sewn? The seam came apart, did it? Yeah. What happened to yours?
I bought a jumper, and when I brought it home, I took it off the hanger, off the shelf, and she went behind the back and got me another one and left it in the window. And when I took it home, she wrapped it up in a bag. When I brought it home, there's a hole in the back of the jumper, so I took it back. But it was the last one that they had, and they wouldn't take the one out the window. Uh-huh. So I had to leave it there, I had to pick it up 2 days later.
You had to wait for another one, yes. What happened with you?
A pair of trousers.
What happened?
The seam come undone. Uh-huh. And I went into it and I ripped it. But it didn't get ripped, it just, you know, burst open.
Who are the people that might be able to help you if the shop wouldn't help you? Any ideas, anybody? Citizens Advice Bureau, fine, yep.
Anybody else, yeah?
Any other names?
Food Descriptions Act or something, where you complain to a certain person, he goes to the shop, and if you're right, the manager can be put out of business or something.
You mean the food, the public health inspectors?
Yes,
for food complaints, that's another thing, yes. Did you know that you've got a consumer advice centre quite near here in Wandsworth? Did you know that?
Anybody heard of consumer advice centres?
Yeah. None. In fact, if you did have problems about things that had gone wrong, shoes had fallen to pieces or something wrong with sweaters or something of that sort, you could actually go to the advice centre. It's in Wandsworth.
Well, one of the things we'd like to do with the newspaper eventually, and we've actually done it on the back page, is to give you some idea of the Acts of Parliament that give you some protection. But the application of those Acts, and obviously it's a good idea for you to know their names and what they do, the application of those acts depends on two things. One, helping yourself, Citizens Advice Bureau, consumer advice centres, things like that, who can help you to get redress, your rights under the law. Or there are other people like trading standards officers and public health inspectors who also can do things for you within that aspect of the law.
Good advice there from Norman. Well, I was at the Elliott School as well, and after that discussion I asked the youngsters if they were now more interested in consumer affairs. They all replied that they were. In fact, they were even planning to do their own consumer survey on fish and chips.